and girls, how are you? It is a beautiful day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. So before we go to our lesson, I want us to begin with a word of prayer. So let us put our hands together, bow down, and let us pray. Everlasting Father, we come before you this beautiful Sunday that you have granted us. We thank you for your mercies that are new. We thank you for your goodness. Thank you for preserving us and for protecting us. We thank you for the children who are even here, Jehovah King, today to listen to your word. We ask for your blessing upon them and upon their families. Father, even as we begin this lesson, we ask that you be with us. May you guide us. May you teach us. And that we may be transformed by your word and to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And all the children said, amen. Okay, so this beautiful morning, we want to look at a topic about Christmas. It is already a Christmas. December is a festive season. Christmas is fast approaching. And we want to study about, the lesson today is about Jesus, the precious gift. So before we go into our lesson, I want to welcome a song from a children's choir, St. Mark's Children's Choir, and also a presentation by Emmanuel. Okay, so enjoy.
Oh,
So thank you very much, Children's Choir, for that beautiful Christmas song. Thank you also, Emmanuel, for that beautiful Christmas presentation. So we will go now into our lesson. Our topic is Jesus, the precious gift. And our lesson today is about the Annunciation. About the Annunciation. So I want you boys and girls to get your Bibles. We will be looking at the book of Luke, chapter 1, from verse 26 all the way to 38. So I want you to open your Bibles, get your notebooks ready, your pens ready. Open Luke 1, 26 all the way to 38. So this is a beautiful, beautiful story about the introduction of Jesus Christ, how he would come into the world. And it begins with a story of an angel called Gabriel. Gabriel is an angel, and he was sent by God to come and deliver the news to a virgin called Mary. And Mary lived in a town called Nazareth. So Nazareth is actually in Galilee. So a town called Nazareth, Mary was just going on doing her work, and she was pledged to be married to somebody called Joseph. I know we are familiar with that story. Joseph, who was also a descendant of David. Remember in the Old Testament, we've been reading some time back about the last Sunday, actually, we were looking at the prophecy of Jesus Christ. It had already been announced in the Old Testament by various prophets that Jesus would be born in Nazareth, and Jesus was going to be born through virgin, and her name is actually Mary. So 26, verse 26, that is the introduction. We see the angel coming, finding Mary, and the first thing that the angel does, the angel brings greetings and says, "Greetings to you, Mary, you who is highly favored and blessed." And then Mary actually wondered what type of a greeting this would be, because it was a surprise to see somebody coming, greeting her, and telling her, "You are highly blessed." And then when you continue down, verse number 30, the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid," because that is our first reaction when somebody comes to you. And Gabriel actually was an angel, so we can imagine the angel just appeared like that. Yeah? And so the first reaction of Mary was to be afraid. And that's why the angel had to reassure her, "Mary, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. You have found favor with God. And you will be with a child and give birth to a son. And you are to give him the name Jesus Christ." So the name of Jesus was already given beforehand. Okay. "And he will be great, and he will be called the Most High, Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his father David." We have already mentioned that Joseph, who is actually the earthly father of Jesus Christ, yeah, Joseph was a descendant of David. And that's why the explanation here that Jesus would be given the throne of his father David. "And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever." He will reign over the house of Jacob forever. So the kingdom of God, the kingdom of Jesus Christ here on earth, was not to be compared with the earthly kingdoms that have an end. But the kingdom of Jesus Christ, we are told, it will reign forever and ever. It will last forever and ever. So the first question that Mary asks, how will this be? Because remember, she's a virgin. She is pledged to be married to Joseph. And she didn't understand how this would be, that she would conceive a child. So the angel told her, "You will conceive a child," and already the name has been given. And now the angel had to explain that the power of the Most High God would come upon Mary, and that's how she was going to conceive and give birth to a baby called Jesus Christ. Okay, so what I want to emphasize so much is verse 37. It says, "For nothing is impossible with God." For nothing is impossible with God. So even the conception of Jesus Christ, It defied all the knowledge that we have. But this verse actually explains it all, that with God, nothing is impossible. With God, nothing is impossible. And then I also want to emphasize number 38. What was Mary's response? After she was told about the baby that she was going to conceive and give back, what was Mary's response? Do we know the answer that Mary gave? So it is found in verse number 38, which is our last verse. Mary answered and said, I'm the Lord's servant. May it be to me as you have said. Then the angel left her. So here, Mary did not refuse. Mary did not give any excuse. But her answer is what I want us to learn from today. Mary said that, let it be unto me according to what the angel had said. Yeah, she accepted. And it came to be exactly that. Because we know in the other chapters that follow that, we see the baby was born. So Christmas time is actually a time where we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. And it comes once every year. This is where we remember the precious gift that God himself gave to mankind. Because if Jesus Christ was not born, then our salvation would not have come through. That's why we are saying the topic today is Jesus, the precious gift. It is through the birth of Jesus Christ that salvation came to you and to me and to the entire of mankind in the whole world. Okay, so what do we learn from this story? How can we apply this story in our life? So we learn that Mary lived a life that pleased God. Mary lived a life that pleased God. She was obedient and she was pure. And out of it, we saw that an angel came and told her she's highly favored. So we learn that we need to be obedient, listen to our parents, do the things that are right according to what we are taught in the Bible, in the Sunday school, and by our teachers. And through that, we see that blessings of God will find us. God has great things in store for us when we are obedient to his will. Okay, so that is what we learn. And then when you hear the voice of God, do not doubt it. Just take a step of faith, believe, and it will be done as God has said. Because God is not a liar. He does not lie. His word remains true. So Mary actually was receptive and said, let it be done unto me according to what the angel had said to her. Okay, so I hope, boys and girls, you've learned something there. And that we will begin to apply. We will begin to be obedient children. We will begin to live a life that pleases God. And that way we will be favored. That way we will receive the blessings of God. So at this point in time, I want to welcome the memory verse, which is coming from Isaiah 9:6. It will be given to us by Emmanuel Keegan. Welcome.
My name is Emmanuel Keegan. Our memory verse comes from Isaiah 9:6. It says, for to us a child is born, for to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Emmanuel, for that memory verse, Isaiah 9:6. It has shown to us the prophecy about Jesus Christ, and that he will be called Wonderful Counselor. He will be called Almighty God. He will be called Eternal Father, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Those are the qualities and the attributes of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So I want us to close with a word of prayer. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. So boys and girls, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. Enjoy the season and remember that Jesus is the reason for the season. Merry Christmas. Bye-bye. God bless you all.
you.